what was your intent with the script of Mission Kashmir, and to what extent did you see that intent accomplished?
That was one of the moments where it became clear to me that film was not my bag, as it were. Because I think in the way that film works is the way I had imagined it, and I think the way all of us had imagined it, first was a much smaller movie, you know, and much more intimate and personal. And then, I mean, at the beginning it had just been two of us working, then it became three, then it became four. And so, as a fiction writer, I'm so used to sitting down at my laptop and being in complete control and also, you know, completely responsible for whatever I put together, right? And in film, that doesn't work at all. It's always collaborative, and especially on that project it was. So there were many tuggings, I want this to happen, but no, this is going to happen, back and forth. And then also the film, I think, became bigger and bigger, and therefore then as a function of the way budgeting works and the way monies work, I mean, you know, I could feel frustrated but it's not my investment that's like making that thing happen, right? So I have to say, I mean, I think there were parts of the film, especially in the first like 30-40 minutes, that I think were closest to how I had imagined it. And then as it went further and it became something else that I wasn't quite imagining in my head when we had started to make it. But I think that's partly just a function of the way the medium is, right? You can't be involved in it as a writer and act all hurt afterwards and pretend that, you know, I was... And, you know, literary writers who've gone into Hollywood, for instance, you know, the Fitzgerald and Faulkner and so forth, this is why they've come out at the other end drinking themselves to oblivion. You know? Because once you're in there, then you're in there for the whole haul. You know, you can't suddenly act snobby. You know? So again, you know, that's what one of the reasons that I just thought, bhaiya, you know, this is all very fun, and it's it's a charge. You write a small scene and the actors who are wonderful come in and do something with it which is just extraordinary, and all of a sudden it's like 50 feet high on a screen, you know, and the emotions of it are just like immensely powerful. That part is really good, you know. And then the other part which is not so good is that something that you worked on for months, you know, suddenly so-and-so star says on the set, yeah, I can't say these lines, let's think of something else. And then suddenly it's being, you know, fiddled with by... So that's, you know, like I was saying, that's what I thought was like, it's better for me to work at a distance from it and not be that sort of involved on a day-to-day basis in this whole thing. Although I have to say that after I'm saying all this, like in the way the writers do, there's some chance that Sacred Games might get made into a television series. Let's see.
AMC.
Yeah, well, we're hoping, yes. And as in the case of the Filmi Duniya Everywhere, it's not made until it's made, right? So one doesn't really know.
Right.
But even there, I was asked at the beginning, you know, do you want to do the adaptation? And I said, no, thanks. I am too close to it, you know. And I think for a really good adaptation anyway, it's necessary to do certain pretty radical things to it, right? And I couldn't have done that. And so we have a very talented writer named Carrie Williamson who's working on the adaptation. And when I first saw her work, I was blown away by it. And I was so happy that I had decided not to try and do it, because she was seeing connections and ways of structure that I could have never seen, because I'd already imagined it one way.
Right.
So I'll be involved, but more in a kind of consultant kind of, you know, executive producer kind of way. And then she'll do the actual writing.